started at the basis. We had to, you know, somewhat change the culture. 11 years ago, we started, and it comes with belief. It comes with the ability to, you know, execute a plan. Hey, this is what we have to do in order to compete with the best of the best. I set my expectations high from the very beginning. I've always, you know, I won championships in high school and college. And, you know, I've competed at, you know, in my personal highest level with great coaches. And, you know, so my expectation from the very beginning was we were going to compete. We were going to give everything we got. We were going to be a hard team to beat. We were not going to beat ourselves. And so when the guys bought into that, and it took a little time and it took a little development. Obviously, you have to have basketball skills. And so we revamped the intramural program. We introduced a spring intramural program in the middle school, and we got a lot more kids playing. Our first spring intramural program that we put together, we had 82 kids sign up. And those fifth graders were the seniors who won it 2 years ago, 2018. And so it was just an evolution of all those, you know, hard work and staying in the system, developing and believing in the mission of the program and what we wanted to do. And slowly but surely, it happened in the fourth year. Get guys like Eric Wade, Rashad Bolden to, you know, anchor the program down. And, you know, it's all about the horses. You got to have good horses. And so I owe a lot to those players. And I owe a lot to the administration for giving me a chance to, you know, put in the program and to allow me to, you know, develop these boys in the best way I knew how while accommodating the San Diego Chargers.
How has seeing those kids develop and coaching those kids develop over a period of time made you a better coach?
And so what we did was created a culture of family. Hey, I know Rashad, you know, I know this guy, I know Jake, I know all these guys. I'm going to go watch them play tonight. Rather than, you know, I'm in middle school, I'm going to do my own thing. You know, we're trying to get you ready for this level. And I think the more they were exposed to the upper school and the high school, see that these guys were competing at a high level. Like, you know, hey, I want to do that one day. And then our middle school coaches did a great job of letting them know, well, if you want to do that, these are things you have to do. And so we try to develop basketball as something that it's not just, you know, one season, that's it. It's a way of life, and you know, part of who you are, part of your DNA, and sent in the. And if you want to be known for what you did, then you have to put in the work. You have to, you know, pay the price and become part of the program. And so I think that's kind of what started. There's no way I can take credit for the development of, you know, some of the superstars we have. Those guys put in their own work, and I'm never going to take credit for them. I will say that they believed in me and my mission, and they believed in what I wanted to do. And therefore, they carried out what I asked of them. So credit goes to those guys and what they accomplished. I was just lucky enough to be a part of it. But those guys put in all the hard work and the long time in the summer. And they're gym rats. And, you know, so I can't take credit for that. So I'm just lucky to coach those kind of players.
For sure, for sure. And, of course, you know, the guy that stands out to me, this is my first year here in the area. And seeing Rashad, the way he performed this year was pretty great. And I know he's going to be a rising senior next year. What do you think his potential is?
A lot of people want to talk about what a great basketball player he is. And there's no doubt, he's all those things. But he's also unbelievably smart in the classroom. And so, you know, he went to visit Harvard and so many Ivy League schools last summer. And that's the type of caliber that Rashad Bolden is. So, you know, I think his potential is whatever he wants to be. And, you know, he's so smart. He's a student of the game. You know, I can see he watches film. And, you know, he watches just as much film as I did. And, you know, we talk about it. And he's a true student of the game. And we got to the point we thought just alike and how to manage the game. And he would pick up some weaknesses of the other team like I would. And, but he... he was just so much fun to coach because it was someone who cared about it as much as I did. And so, to me, I consider him a co-assistant coach. You know, and that's what a point guard should be. A point guard needs to be your assistant coach on the floor, and that's the way I've always believed point guard should be. That's the way I wanted to be when I played. And Rashad naturally is taking that role. And he's been trained well by his dad, and you know, they got basketball games in their family. So the credit goes to them. He just bought in, and he wanted to be coached, and he let me coach him. But he also taught me a lot of things along the way.
What's the future for you?
You know, I've always considered myself an entrepreneur, if you will. I've dabbled in business my whole life, and early in my career, I love to coach, and truthfully, I just love a challenge. And, you know, at the time, 11 years ago, San Andreas was a challenge. They won very few games and, you know, wasn't really talked about. And the more people told me not to take that job, the more I wanted it. And so I wanted that challenge to change something, to fix something, to implement something, if you will. And, you know, I started a construction company years ago and recently sold that back in 2018. So there's some things that I want to do in my life, and so I'm going to go into the private equity investment world, and you know, and I look forward to the next opportunity to kind of spread my wings and be challenged again. And I've always believed that there's no progress in the comfort zone, and I just need to get back out of my comfort zone. And as hard as it is, I feel like it's the best thing for my family and myself, and I'm going to miss terribly all those players and St. Andrews especially, but I know they understand because I've always teaching, I've always preached, you got to get out of your comfort zone if you want to get better. And so this is me taking my own advice.
For sure. And look, and sometimes it's hard for us to do that, you know what I mean? So salute to you for doing that, man. And I also wanted to just get a little background on you. I know you you played at Clinton, played at MRA. You won here in the high school level, won here locally, and you won here locally as a coach. And you've done all that. Now, do you have a hearing aid that helps you during the game? Like, have you had that? Have you had to deal with that your whole life, or is that something that's come up in the last couple of years? And you've been able to have success. I mean, we hear those stories. I mean, I did a story on the coach at the Mississippi School for the Deaf. He had a connection with Kobe Bryant, and it was great talking with him. And you know, I covered kids in Alaska. There's one girl, she went to Gallaudet in D.C. for a little while, played for that program. And it seems like everywhere I go, there's someone that's proving that whether you have any sort of disability or impairment, it doesn't stop you from pursuing dreams and being successful.
Well, you know, it's a funny story about Sika White and I played together in Taiwan. We played on the United States Deaf Olympic basketball team. And so I got to meet Sika back in 2009, right before my first season at San Andreas, and played basketball with him. Incredible basketball player, incredible human being. And so that was my one connection to Sika. But I was born deaf. I grew up with hearing aids my whole life. But, you know, they're not waterproof. So when you start sweating, you take your hearing aids off. And you know, I used to tell Coach Luis that I couldn't hear him. I would turn my hearing aids off. And I start calling my own plays because, you know, he and I had, we had some disagreements. But he trusted me, you know, again, as a point guard on the floor. And, you know, I never had the chance to wear hearing aids during the whole game. They get wet or sweat. So, I played really without hearing anything. And so that's the way I played the game. But as far as coaching the game, you know, I wanted to make sure, you know, I really didn't need to hear too much. I just didn't know what was going on. And the player wanted to tell me something, make sure I'm looking at them. If I'm mad at you, don't tell me anything. Just move on. But I think, you know, it was definitely a challenge at some time, but I didn't let it get in the way of what we were trying to accomplish, and neither did the players. You know, they didn't hold it against me. They worked with me, and I disability, you know, and everybody's got something, you know, and, you know, we did, you know, some are more obvious than others, but I think communication is key, and I think at the team, we always communicate, and we told each other, and, you know, a lot of people just don't do that these days.
Right. For sure, man. Well, look, you've done great. Like, the more I've seen you, like, I've covered some of the games, and just hearing about you, what you've been able to do at that program is really great, really amazing, man. And I know that program's in good hands. Wish you all the best, man. Like, we'll be keeping tabs, you know what I mean? Whatever comes down the line, even if you become a sponsor of an event, you know what I mean? Of a tournament, you never know, you know what I mean? But you done great at St. Andrews, man, and congrats. And way to bow on top. A lot of coaches, you know, they kind of, but you're going out on top, man. So we appreciate it. Thanks for your time, man. Wish you all the best.
Hey, no problem. Thank you for having me, and just like anything else, it may not work out. It may work out, but at the end, I've always believed in, you know, going for it. You know, and just doing everything you can. And I'm a big believer that you got to push for it, and you got to set your goals higher and higher every year. And if you're not, you're not really living life. And, you know, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. But I'm grateful to obviously win a state championship with my boys. I leave and just wait, and you know, got a good team coming back, got a great program. So whoever takes it, I think they'll have a whole lot of fun. It's gonna be a lot better than when I got it with 11 years ago. And that's all you wanna do. You wanna leave a small mark you wanna leave something better than you found it. And so thank you for giving me the opportunity to speak about St. Andrews. And, I love the school. I love all the players. And I'm not going far. I'm gonna be there to root them on. I think they got what it takes to win next year. So we'll see what happens.